Today, we're going to take a look at 6 AI-powered features built into Final Cut Pro and how you can utilize them to help you edit more efficiently. First, let's take a look at the 2 new AI-powered features added in the Final Cut Pro 11 update, the Magnetic Mask and Auto Captions. If you've ever had to manually rotoscope a clip, you know how much of a time saver an automatic rotoscoping tool can be. And that's exactly what Final Cut Pro's Magnetic Mask is, an automatic rotoscoping tool. And it's probably the best one I've ever used. Very easy to use and super fast. Let's use it to place text behind a moving subject. Down in my timeline, I have a stock clip of a man dancing. First thing we need to do is make a copy of this clip and layer it directly above the original. Select the bottom clip and press V to disable it for now. Select the top clip again, go to the effects browser, and select the masks and key in category. Grab a magnetic mask effect and add it to your top layer. In the viewer window, your cursor will turn to an eyedropper tool. Use it to click on your subject. Final Cut Pro uses artificial intelligence to analyze your clip and select your subject for you. In this case, it knew exactly what I was selecting. Click the Analyze button to track and automatically rotoscope your subject. Final Cut Pro does this insanely fast. Click Done to isolate your subject and remove the background. Go to your Titles and Generators browser, grab the title you want to place in this clip, and add it between your two layers. Replace the text and make it look exactly the way you want. Re-enable your bottom clip to reveal your background again. With your rotoscope subject as a top layer, title in the middle, and your original clip at the bottom, you get the school, text behind the moving subject effect. Let's try one more, harder example. In this next clip, we have a couple people jogging through a forest, even running behind a tree towards the end of the clip. Let's see how Final Cut Pro does with this. Same as before, make a copy of your clip and disable the bottom layer for now. Add a magnetic mask to your top clip and click on your subject to select them. If Final Cut Pro misses any parts, you can easily add them to your mask by clicking on the missed parts. You can also remove parts from a mask by holding down the Option key and clicking on them. Now, in this clip, we have more than one subject we need to rotoscope. Final Cut Pro lets you add multiple masks to a clip. To add another mask, go up to the top right corner of your viewer window and click the Add Mask button. Select your second subject and, if necessary, adjust the mask. Since we have 2 masks in this clip, we have to analyze it twice. Analyze your clip to track and rotoscope your selected mask. And once you're done, select your second mask in the inspector window and click the Analyze button to analyze your clip again. Click Done and skim through your clip to check for accuracy. It actually did really good here. Select your bottom clip and press V to re-enable it. Let's maybe go to the color inspector and bring down the saturation of the background for this cool effect. Because Final Cut Pro uses AI for this, even when our subjects were completely obstructed by the tree in the front, we never lost our mask. I've tried almost every rotoscoping tool out there for Final Cut Pro, and this is by far the best one. The second AI-powered feature added in the Final Cut Pro 11 update is Transcribe to Captions. This is something me and a lot of other Final Cut Pro users were waiting for a long time. And just like the magnetic mask, this is also super fast and simple to use. To add captions to your project, select all the clips you want to caption, and from the Enhancements drop-down menu, select Transcribe to Captions. In just seconds, Final Cut Pro transcribes all your selected clips and converts it to closed captions in your project. Now, unfortunately, you can't use this for always-on subtitles, but there is aftermarket software out there that can convert captions to animated subtitles. Let me know if you're interested in the video on that topic. But as of right now, all you can do is closed captions. Another AI feature in Final Cut Pro that's really handy is Smooth Slo-Mo. See, when you have a clip shot at a regular frame rate, or even at a higher frame rate, like 60 frames per second, and you try to slow it down beyond the available frames, it does not look good. You either get choppy playback, or if you use optical flow, you get some wonky movements. In the Final Cut Pro 10.8 update, we got another option for slow motion. Apple calls this Smooth Slo-Mo, and it's way better than anything we've had before. There's a few different ways to apply this to your clip. The easiest way to do it is when you open your retime menu, either under the viewer window or down in your timeline. Instead of selecting one of the slow options, select one of the smooth slow-mo presets. Final Cut Pro will analyze your clip, and instead of just blending frames to make additional frames needed, Final Cut Pro uses machine learning to learn what's actually in your frames and uses AI to generate new frames based on that information. The results look so much better. And we're not limited to just the three presets either. You can slow it down to a custom speed. And to make sure Final Cut Pro uses machine learning, just make sure video quality is set to best. One thing I do recommend with this is if you don't have background render turned on, make sure to render these clips for nice smooth playback. The 10.8 update also included the enhanced light and color feature. This feature uses machine learning to analyze your clips and automatically enhance the exposure and colors in your image, removing any visible color cast. This is a great way to quickly color correct your clips. Just select your clip in the timeline, open the enhancements pop-up menu under the viewer, and select Enhance Light and Color. Final Cut Pro will analyze your clip and make any necessary adjustments. You can further adjust this in the Color Inspector, where you can further tweak the light and color adjustments. The Enhanced Light and Color feature is a great way to quickly fix any brightness issues or color cast in your clips, but it's not a replacement for proper color grading. It's just not there yet. And the last two features we've had for quite a while now. First, we have Smart Conform. This feature allows you to easily make social media friendly versions of your projects in square or vertical formats. Select your project, right click on it, and select Duplicate Project As. Change your video format to either vertical or square, and select the Smart Conform checkbox. Final Cut Pro will analyze each clip in your timeline and automatically adjust the framing for each clip based on specific video content, such as faces or other areas of visual interest, so these important elements are never out of frame. The only bad thing here is if your subject moves, it doesn't automatically track them. You have to manually do this with the Transform tool and keyframes. I'm pretty sure we're going to get an update in the near future, so you don't have to do this manually. Final Cut Pro for iPad already has this feature, so it's only a matter of time before it comes to the Mac version of Final Cut Pro. And, as always, I saved the best for last. Voice isolation. I use this for basically every video I make. Final Cut Pro's voice isolation uses Apple's neural engine to analyze the audio in your clips, enhance speech, and optimize sound levels while reducing background noise from audio captured out in the field. In my demo clip, I'm trying to talk while driving, and the road noise and car sounds are very distracting. But sometimes, I gotta throw in a couple clips shot on my... If I select this clip, go up to the audio inspector, and turn on voice isolation, listen to how much better it sounds. But sometimes, I gotta throw in a couple clips shot on my iPhone. And that's with voice isolation set to only 50%. If I crank it all the way up, the road and car noises are almost completely gone. Sometimes, I gotta throw in a couple clips shot on my iPhone. But it does affect my voice, so I'd recommend playing around with the amount until you find that happy spot between removing background noise, but still having your voice sound normal. I gotta throw in a couple clips shot on my iPhone. It's also really useful to remove reverb and echo. For example, this clip's audio was recorded with my camera's internal mic. What if I told you you don't need fancy lighting, expensive microphones, or even a camera to make videos? It doesn't sound very good at all. But if we enable voice isolation and leave it at the default 50%, listen to how much better my audio sounds. What if I told you you don't need fancy lighting, expensive microphones, or even a camera to make videos? I don't recommend relying on this, but it's a great tool to have if you're in a bind. Even if you have good audio, turning on voice isolation and setting the amount to between 20 and 30% is a great way to remove subtle background noises and make your voice stand out. This is what I do in basically all my videos. The difference may be subtle, but it is noticeable. These six AI tools included in Final Cut Pro aren't life-changing, but when you need them, it sure feels like it. And with Apple focusing more and more on Apple Intelligence, I'm sure there's more amazing AI tools coming in the near future. As soon as they're out, I'll be sure to cover them on this channel. Hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.